Hey kids, welcome back to Clean Slate Farm. Today we're going to be making fermented garlic dill pickles, just like I used to have when I was a kid. So I'm going to pick some cucumbers, get some dill, this stuff back here, a few grape leaves, some garlic that we harvested, and we're going to go inside, make some pickles. Stick around. All right, we've got everything out of the garden, and now we're going to talk about brine, because brine is the key to fermentation. Brine is what makes an inhospitable environment for bad bacteria and a hospitable for good bacteria, and that bacteria is the lactobacillus bacteria. We're creating lactic acid, but again, the brine concentration is key to this. So I've got three different salts here because I want to show you the difference. You can't use a volume measurement, you have to use a weight measurement, because volume is going to vary, and that's what I'm going to show you here. I've got Himalayan sea salt, I've got Malden salt, and I've got kosher salt. All three have a different crystalline structure, which makes the weight different per volume. So let's get the scale on, and we'll show you that. Okay, let's tear the scale. We're at zero. Let's weigh the Himalayan sea salt. That weighs in at 17 grams for a tablespoon. Let's weigh the Malden sea salt. Weighs in at 7 grams. Let's weigh the kosher salt. 9 grams. So you can see there's a difference. 8 grams, 9 grams. Closer to 9 grams. So you can see there's a difference in the salt based on the crystalline structure of the salt. That's going to make a big difference when you make your brine. So why does the salt weigh different? Well, you can see that the Himalayan salt is fine. It's almost like flour. The Malden salt, very coarse, very flaky, very defined crystalline structure. And over here, you've got the kosher salt, and you can see how small the crystals are. But what it boils down to is air. The volume of air inside the measurement by volume is going to make a difference on how much you weigh out. So you can't use a volume measurement, and you have to use a weight measurement. For yucks, what I did was I weighed out some pickling salt, and that weighs 20 grams per tablespoon. Now the brine concentration I want to keep a crunchy pickle is like 3.5 to 4% brine concentration. So I'm going to use 40 grams of salt to 4 cups of water and a quart of water. That will do what I wanted to do. What else can you use to keep your pickles crunchy? Well, there's a thing called pickle crisp, and that's calcium chloride. USDA says it's safe for fermenting and it's safe for quick pickles. You would use that to this concentration. You would use 1/4 of a rounded teaspoon per quart of water. Not going to use that. Actually, I will use that. We're going to put some in one of these jars and we're going to do an A-B test. There's also a thing called alum. Now, alum is, what is alum? Alum is potassium sulfite. Sulfate. And I'm not going to use alum. It's considered safe for food use, but I'm not going to use it in my pickles. I don't want to use that. Finally, on salt, never use iodized table salt. Iodized table salt is iodine in it to prevent clumping and caking. You don't want that. That's going to hinder the bacteria that you're trying to promote. So let's put everything together and start making some pickles. All right, I've got 1 quart of water and 40 grams of pickling salt, and I'm just going to dissolve the salt in the water. Stir it around until it's dissolved. Now, another thing you can do that I've used, and you saw me pick the grape leaves. Let me tell you a little bit about those while I'm stirring. Grape leaves have tannin in them. You can also use oak leaves or cherry leaves. They have tannins as well. I've heard that you can use bay leaves because there's tannin in that. I've never done that, oak or cherry leaves. I've always used grape leaves. So I don't know if it does any good or not. I think the concentration, well, I know the concentration of salt works a lot better than what the grape leaves did, because I've made pickles before with grape leaves, and they came out okay, but I think you got to use an awful lot of grape leaves, or maybe the right age grape leaves, I don't know. The brine concentration seems to me the better way to go. I'm going to put some in for fun. So we're going to stir this up a little bit, make sure we got that. We're going to start packing our jars. Actually, what we're going to do before we start packing our jars is going to talk about the fermentation process and carbon dioxide that it creates and why you need to burp your jars or have something that will burp the jars for you automatically, such as a water lock. I'm going to show you something that's even more fun than a water lock, and that I really love this product. Now, when fermentation gets going, what's going to happen is it's going to create carbon dioxide in the jar. If you have a tight-fitting lid, that's going to create pressure because carbon dioxide wants to displace the oxygen in the jar. Now, what you can do is just put a loose-fitting lid with a piece of paper towel or something, kind of like I do with the kombucha. You can do that. Or you can use an air lock, which is it's a water lock, little hole in the top of the jar with a water lock thing. You use that for like fermenting beer and fermenting wine. Or you can use what I found, these handy little guys here, which is called a pickle pebble. And it's a silicone seal, and in the top here, it's got a slit cut into it. When you put this on and screw the cap down, as carbon dioxide is created in here, it automatically burps. If you don't have something like that, like the water lock, or an open container, like something to weight everything down, what's going to happen is you're going to build up too much pressure. When you open it up, boom, you're going to get stuff all over you. This is a handy little device. I love these. There's another device that I've got, and it is from Trellis & Company, and it's a similar thing. It's a stainless steel lid, and it's got a little four holes punched in the top with a little silicone seal that you put on top, and it holds that down. As carbon dioxide is created, it pops open and releases that gas but doesn't let air back in. You don't want air. Air's not good for pickling. So, we got our jars, we got our concentration. Oh, one other thing. To hold everything down, whatever you're fermenting has to be held below the level of brine. Anything above the level of brine is not going to pickle, and you run a chance of it running, going bad and spoiling your fermentation. Along with the pickle pipes is a pickle pebble. It's just a glass weight that's going to sit in the jar. You'll see that in a couple of seconds. These things are great too. Both of these are available from a company called Mason Tops, and I'll post a link down below if you're interested in buying those. You can the pickle pipes and the pickle pebbles, there's three of these, four of these for like $35. One of the best investments I've ever made for fermenting. So let's start packing jars. And we'll get going here. Hey, when I'm making pickles, the first thing I do is I fold up the grape leaf and I put it in the bottom of the jar, like so. You can cut them up also. But again, you want to make sure there's no air in there, so we're going to put two leaves in each one. We're going to rip this one up a little bit and put that one in there. Put that in there. There's a small one. We'll throw that in there. Next, I'm going to add my garlic. I've got about two cloves, small to medium-sized cloves per. Your preference on what you want. Now we're going to add our dill. And I'm just going to take this. Snip that off and drop the dill in there. You can use fresh dill heads like I picked or the seed heads. Doesn't really matter. I find that about two good sized heads really does a nice job. So what I did was I overpicked here. That's plenty in there. And we should be good to go. Now we're going to pack our cucumbers in. Wipe everything off here. We got a lot more cucumbers than we need, don't we? Jam them down in there. Make sure they're good and tight in there. And you're going to need some headspace up in here for the pickle pebble or your weight. Another thing you can do is you can use a grape leaf on top. That will help out. Jam them down in there good. Pack all the little spaces. We're getting close here, kids. These are a really good pickle. It's a great recipe. And you can follow this recipe and make your own. And they are delicious. Now, y'all don't have to use cubes like I'm using. I generally make spears, but today I'm using cubes for I don't know what reason. I just decided to use cubes. Put that over there. Add our brine. Bring it right up to the top. Make sure everything is underneath there. I'm going to give them a little shake like this to help release some air that might be trapped. I'm going to put the pickle pebble on top. Push it down. Now I'm assured that everything is underneath that brine. And I don't have to add any more brine to that. Wipe my hands off. Screw in our lids. We'll label and date these. And we're off and running. These will take a few days to ferment. Now, to keep track of what you got going on, I use just some packing tape and just write on it what I did. So today is 21 August, and that's about a 4%. 4%. Stick it on the side of the jar, leave it at room temperature. Now, this is going to take about, in these temperatures, about 4 or 5 days. You're going to start to see some fermentation going on pretty quickly here. Every once in a while, you want to pick up the jar, shake it, release like this, and that's going to help release some air and get the air out of there. I can see that happening already just because it wasn't packed well enough. And then after about 4 or 5 days, fermentation happens at those temperatures I spoke about earlier, like 55, 60 degrees to 75, 80 degrees. And what you want to do is, when everything is fermented, to stop the fermentation or to slow the fermentation, refrigerate it. That's what I have here. Now, these are two different brine solutions. We're going to cut these, and I'm going to show you the difference there. But again, once your pickle starts to go, you're going to start to see some cloudiness, like you can see in the bottom of this jar here. Nothing wrong with that. Don't worry about it. It's supposed to happen. That's the process of fermentation. The water, the brine's going to turn cloudy. Nothing wrong with it at all. You may pick up some white foam or white scum on the top. Don't worry about it. It's nothing at all. It's just the fermentation process happening. If you pick up some black mold that looks like it's spreading and it's got like little cat-like hairs spreading out from that, appropriately enough, it's called cat hair bacteria. And you want to get that off of there and throw the pickle away. It's no good. Don't trust it by saying, well, I'll just scrape it off, because bacteria like that can go right down to the bottom. You won't even see it. Toss the pickle. It's not worth your health to screw around with it. But if it's just a white scum on there, it's perfectly fine. My uncle used to do these in crocks, big 5-gallon crocks. It was white scum on it all the time. We just pulled the pickle out and ate it. But let's take a look at these guys. Two different concentrations. This is 21 grams of salt to 1 quart. So this is about a 2.5%, 2% brine. And this one I know was a 35 grams to a quart of water. So that's about a 3.5% brine. So let me get a plate out. We're going to cut them and see what the difference is. Okay, bozo alert. Mustard seeds. Put a tablespoon of mustard seeds into each jar as well. I forgot to do that because I was so concentrating on the brine solution. Tablespoon of mustard seed doesn't hurt it at all. So what I've done is, these are the ones that are in the fridge. This one is from 31st of July, 21 grams of salt to 1 quart of water. So that is roughly a 2% brine, 2.5% brine. This one I know is a 35 grams to 1 quart. So that's a little bit more. That's like a 3% or better. These again are like 4, give or take a little bit more. Here's the pickle here from the 2% brine. Still got crunch to it, great garlic and dill taste, terrific product. And this is the one with the more concentrated brine, the 3.5%. Sorry, you can hear me crunching and swallowing. Hazards of video. That's very good too. It's a little saltier, more garlicky, so I must have put more garlic into that one. But good stuff. Finally, here I had cucumbers left over. I didn't want to throw them out, and I can't eat any more cucumbers. So I put them in a jar, put some grape leaves in the bottom, some dill in the bottom, the garlic in the bottom. Oh, and it's spilling out. And what I did was just stuffed grape leaves in the top, packed it down. Everything is underwater. You do not have to have pickle pipes, pickle pebbles, water airlocks, and all that stuff. You can do it perfectly fine just like this. Don't let that stop you from fermenting your own products, because it's great stuff. Hey, thanks for watching. I hope that helps you when you start fermenting your own pickles, and we'll see you later. Thumbs up if you like this video. Please pass it along, and please subscribe if you haven't already. We're over 1,100 subscribers, moving to 1,200, and I really appreciate that. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.